Some CI/CD pipelines take forever to complete, and you may frequently get requests from developers to send them automated messages when their app is deployed, like this. Not only you get the version that was deployed, but also who initiated it and a commit message. Now, if someone breaks the CD pipeline, for instance, the same developer, by making a typo, you'll want to be immediately notified. Argo CD has a notification engine with a few built-in triggers, such as when the app was created, deleted, deployed, among others. All of them can be easily added using annotations. In this tutorial, we'll deploy Argo CD to a brand new local Kubernetes cluster provisioned with Minikube, slightly modified templates, and run a few examples. In this video, I'll use Slack to send messages. However, many other integrations are available and can be added easily using the same method described in this lesson. The source code and all the commands are available in my public GitHub repo. As always, I'll use Terraform to deploy Argo CD from scratch to a brand new Kubernetes cluster. I'll also include Helm commands in case you want to deploy it manually. First, we need to define some version constraints and initialize Helm provider. If you use it locally, simply point it to kubeconfig. If you are using EKS or any other managed Kubernetes service, a better approach is to get a temporary token for authorization. Next, we have Argo CD Helm release. At the beginning of the file, you'll find commands to deploy it manually. It's exactly the same as Terraform configuration below. We'll use the latest Helm version and override some default variables. First, we want to disable HTTPS endpoint. Even in production, we would use ingress and secure it with TLS if necessary. Next, we need to deploy notification controller, which will be deployed as a separate pod that will watch events from the Argo CD. Let's avoid creating the secret and config map with templates for now. We'll do it step by step manually. As you go through this example, you might potentially include those configurations from the beginning in Helm, but for now, let's disable both. Now, let's spin up a local Kubernetes cluster using Minikube, or you can use any other tool to create a cluster. Switch to the Terraform folder, initialize the state and download providers. Then apply to deploy Argo CD Helm chart. Argo CD deploys many microservices and open source projects. For now, we're interested in the notification controller. I would suggest from the beginning to tail logs, especially when you create new templates. You might make mistakes, and this controller will immediately inform you about issues with your template or integration. For instance, you might not have permissions to post to Slack or Microsoft Teams. Next, let's list all the services in Argo CD. Then we need to get initial admin password generated by Argo CD. All the source code and commands are available in my GitHub repository. Finally, we can port forward and access Argo CD UI locally. Navigate to localhost 8080. The username is admin and the password has been generated for you. Alright, Argo CD is up and running, but it's empty for now. The next step is to create a Slack application. Let's use from scratch option and name it Argo CD. Optionally, you can add icon for this bot. The last step is to grant this bot permissions to post to Slack channels. We need to add a couple of permissions under bot token scope and not user token scope. The first one is chat write. The second is chat write customize. That's it, let's go ahead and install this bot to our workspace. To allow argcd to send messages to Slack, we need to copy the bot user token. Then replace it in argcd notification secret. I must warn you, the secret name and the namespace must be exactly as stated. The same applies to the next config map. Do not change the name. For other integrations like Microsoft Teams, you would create additional secrets within this secret object. In this config map, there are a few important components. First, replace the argcd URL with yours. For instance, if you have external URL included here. It's used solely in the template and will be sent as a Slack message, allowing you to quickly locate the target object. Then keep the Slack token as is. The rest are templates and triggers. For instance, the app deployed template will be triggered every time there is a new version of your app running in the cluster. We'll come back to this later. Lastly, we have argcd application set up to deploy Nginx. Under the annotations, you can list all triggers such as onDeploy, SyncFail, and many others, and specify a Slack channel to post messages. The rest is relatively standard. By the way, I have a full tutorial on argcd and image updater. The link is in description. Now, let's create a Slack channel named Alerts. Most of the time, it will be private. The final step is to invite argcd bot to this channel, otherwise it won't post messages with granted permissions. I have also created an empty public GitHub repo named lesson179 for the deployments. Let's create a folder called Nginx. Next, create an Nginx deployment object starting with version 125.0. Commit with a message like deploy Nginx to the staging environment. In GitHub, you'll notice the new commit. This argcd application will use lesson 179 repo and Nginx path for the deployment. Now apply all three files, the secret, config map, and argcd application. Argcd should immediately detect the new app and deploy it. Once it's done, a Slack message will be sent. This message displays the author of the commit, commit message, source repo, and the current application version in the cluster. Suppose a bug is found and fixed, and we need to update the image version. Let's upgrade to 125.1. Commit with a message like fix the bug and push to the lesson 179 repository. I believe it defaults to a refresh every 5 minutes, but we can manually trigger it for this deployment. Shortly after, you'll receive a Slack message about the newly deployed application version. We can now see the application version, but there are two of them since it also displays the previous version. Let's see how this works in the template. Get the argcd application resource. Within the template, you can access any property of this application. For instance, we get the image version from the summary. You can modify it based on your needs. We have the summary, then the images key with array of strings. In the template, we iterate over these images to create a new attachment. Also, built-in functions are available to get commit authors, messages, and other attributes. For our final test, suppose someone, possibly a developer, broke the CD pipeline with a typo. We want to detect and resolve it immediately. Make a new commit message and push to the remote repository. Refresh the app. By default, it tries to apply the change 5 times before timing out, so it might take about 5 minutes to get a Slack message. You can immediately see the issue in the UI. We eventually receive a message that the CD is broken. You can improve this by adding commit metadata to find who broke it and when. Remember that we added argcd URL during template deployment. Clicking on this link directs us to the broken app in argcd. For those interested, I have a full tutorial on argcd. You can find the link in the description. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.